this morning, and I cannot say enough how incredibly awesome this is. My name is Brian Crane. I Lamasterians.com, Lord Antlers at Cuervo. We kicked this off 17 years ago. 17 years ago, for those who don't know,
yeah.
Pacific. So Armistice Day was created to recognize the cease of hostilities on November 11th at the 11th hour and 11th minute of the 11th month. Well, we're human, and we don't learn from our mistakes all too well. We try, but we didn't do it. And we ended up with another world war. We ended up with a Korean War. We ended up with a Vietnam War. We ended up in a desert much different than this, a lot less fun for a long, long time. And at some point, we realized that maybe we don't always learn from our mistakes. We won't always come together. We won't have that world peace. And that World War I was not the war to end all the wars. But we're going to continue seeing the war. We're going to continue asking our sons and daughters, our brothers and sisters, our mothers and fathers to go out there and do what has to be done. So they changed our Armistice Day to Veterans Day. And now every year on November 11th, so that the entire United States of America takes at least a moment, because it's on every single calendar as a federally recognized holiday, that we thank our men and women that have served this country in any capacity. As veterans, doing what needs to be done. So it is a special day, and this is a special event. somebody to allow them to do what they do and make those sacrifices. And by doing so, they have made those sacrifices themselves. Some of them are unimaginable. Many of us take for granted that when we have a child, you get to see that child say his first words or take his first steps. But not the men and women that have signed up for this, because that's part of writing that check. You sacrifice everything. Things that many of us take for granted. You sacrifice dinners at home. You sacrifice months and months of being away from your family and your loved ones. So those family and those loved ones have had to be more resilient and more strong. They have had to prop us up as veterans and allow us to do what we do. And that's a lot of work for them. That's a big ask. Some of them didn't sign up for it right away. But hopefully all of them have met that and supported you. So can I see if you are a family member or support system of somebody that has wounded in the front, can you please raise your hand? Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, sons and daughters, mothers and fathers, you have somebody in your family that has written a letter, has called home, has talked to you,